Once you have defined your machining strategy with your CAM software, you can export your machining program as G-code or as an APT file, so you can load it in RoboDK to create a robot machining project. In this example, we are using an APT file, so we should also make sure we are using the correct post-processor. Since we are using Mechsoft RhinoCam, we also have the option to send the machining program to RoboDK directly using a batch file. This integration allows you to automatically load the robot machining program from your CAM project using a default setup. From RhinoCam, you can right-click your project and select Post All to generate the machining programs and automatically load everything in RoboDK. The name of the machining program you choose will be the name of the programs we'll see in the controller once we are done generating the files for the robot. You can see that RoboDK automatically splits the robot machining program in the same four machining operations we created. The robot machining project is created using a default robot cell that we can customize. In this case, you see a cooker robot and a default spindle where the tool, or TCP, represents the tool holder. By default, when loading APT programs, RoboDK will add the tools you define in your machining project. The tools will be added to your active TCP when you load the APT file. The correct tools will also be pre-selected in your robot machining project. This is the same menu we can reach by selecting Utilities, Robot Machining Project, and then provide the machining program file. Since we loaded the machining file directly, everything has been created and selected automatically. We can also customize the approach and retract movements in RoboDK. It is better to leave a small approach retract movement on your CAM software. You can customize this later in RoboDK if you need. In short, the robot machining menu allows you to convert any generic 3-axis or 5-axis manufacturing operation to a robot simulation and a robot program. Selecting Update allows you to see if the robot can perform the manufacturing operation. This example is a simple 3-axis machining operation, and the default settings give us a valid result. We have not changed any settings yet. You can select the remaining robot machining operations by holding Shift, then right-click and select Update Programs. As RoboDK calculates the robot machining path, it will create one new robot program for each machining operation. The white icons represent robot programs. These programs are automatically created by RoboDK. You can simulate each program individually by double-clicking on it on the tree. RoboDK also automatically creates a main program that you can run to simulate all robot machining operations in order. You'll see a slider that shows the complete robot machining operation with all the sub-programs. You can right-click your programs and select Generate Robot Programs to generate the program files. In this example, using the default settings, we can already create valid robot programs. Since we are using a KUKA robot, we obtained SRC files that can be loaded on a KUKA KRC controller. You should see the reference and the tool defined in the program the same way you define them in RoboDK. We can also use numbered reference and tool names to use the values stored in the controller given their ID. You can see custom program calls to select the correct tool according to your tool ID and activate the spindle. These settings can be customized in the Program Events menu. You can trigger a special procedure on your robot controller when a certain machining command must be executed, such as changing the tool, the spindle speed, or running M codes. The robot machining project allows you to control how the robot behaves along the machining toolpath. When we are machining, we have a 5-axis constraint. While the position and the cutting axis is properly defined, we have an additional degree of freedom when we use a 6-axis robot arm. This degree of freedom allows us to turn around the cutting axis. This is usually the Z-axis of the tool. You may want to change this orientation by holding the Alt key and grabbing the robot tool. You can also align the tool orientation with the coordinate system by right-clicking on the robot and selecting Align Tool Orientation. By selecting Show Preferred Toolpath, we can preview the tool orientation the robot is trying to follow. By selecting Teach, you're telling RoboDK you want to follow the current tool orientation, so the settings will adjust to to match that orientation. You can select Update and Simulate to see the result. The optimization parameters allow the robot to automatically change the tool orientation if the robot can't achieve the preferred orientation. This parameter is important if you have a large part, if you are working near a singularity, or near the limits of the robot workspace. If you see a red mark, it means the robot cannot perform the operation. If you select Show Estimated Toolpath, you should see in green the positions that are reachable, and it will give you a hint about what the orientations will look like to make the path feasible. This means we are using the additional degree of freedom to automatically avoid robot singularities and axis limits. Once you have customized your settings for one robot machining operation, you can right-click on it, select Copy Settings, bulk select the remaining operations, and select Paste Settings. You can then select Update to recalculate the robot machining programs. You can double-click the main program again to quickly preview the result. And you can finally generate the robot programs to update the SRC files for the robot controller. You can easily change the post-processor by right-clicking a program and selecting Select Post-Processor. If you have a KUKA robot, you should see the KUKA KRC2 post-processor selected by default. This should be compatible with KUKA KRC4 controllers as well. If you prefer, you can still select the KUKA KRC4 post-processor if you have a KRC4 controller. Depending on the robot you use in RoboDK, you should see a default post-processor pre-selected that should generate valid code for your robot controller. RoboDK includes over 80 post-processors to support over 50 robot manufacturers.